गुड इवनिंग टू वन एंड ऑल. आई प्रोफेसर विश्वजीत अंबादे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, तुलसीरामजी गायकवाड पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, वेलकम यू ऑल. एंड ऑनरेबल डॉक्टर जी के आवारी सर, एचओडी ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक नागपुर, फॉर अनादर ग्रेट लेक्चर सीरीज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय AICTE अंडर प्रेरणा स्कीम. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर जी के आवारी सर टू प्रोसीड विद द प्रेजेंटेशन.
Okay, thank you Vishwajit. So let me continue with my topic. So let me check whether I am audible or not. Hello.
Yes sir, you are audible.
Okay, thank you. So let me present my screen. Hello. I hope my screen is visible. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So let me start from the topic of flow through pipes. The last time we have covered some portion of the flow through pipes, so I will go through it again. And in the last class we have studied about the Bernoulli's theorem, then its applications to the venturi meter, orifice meter and the pitot tube. Also we have studied the Buckingham pi theorem, Rayleigh method of the dimensional analysis, and then finally in this lecture we are starting with the flow through pipes. So in the fluid power properties and the fluid mechanics, this will be the last lecture of me, and I will today conclude with the lecture. So the flow through pipes, so let us see the flow through pipes. So contents of my presentation is that the characteristics of the flow through pipes, energy losses in flow through pipes, major losses such as loss of heat due to friction, Darcy-Weisbach formula, minor losses such as loss of head at entry, change in diameter of bend, then problems on head losses, hydraulic gradient line HGL, total gradient energy line TEL, and the effect of entry at pipe and change in diameter and bend etc. on the hydraulic gradient line and total energy line. Then how to plot this HGL, TEL, design of the pipe flow for a given flow using the formula, using nomograms and computation of height of reservoir and the compound pipe and equivalent size. So this is the part of my presentation, today's presentation. So let us see that what do we mean by the laminar flow. So when the fluid moves slowly in layers in a pipe without much mixing among the layers, that is known as the laminar flow. So you can see that, okay, this kind of velocity profiles also we have studied, where at the boundary layer, means at the boundary conditions along the surface of the pipe, it is zero, and here it is also it is zero, and at the center of the pipe it is maximum. So laminar flow, basically the fluid moves in a layers in a pipe and not in the without mixing with the amongst the other layer, and basically not in a zigzag manner. However, in the turbulent flow, it is opposite of the laminar flow, where a considerable mixing occurs, velocities are high, and laminar and turbulent flows can be characterized and the quantified using the Reynolds number. Okay, so you know that Reynolds number is nothing but the rho v d by mu, and we calculate the Reynolds number, and based on the Reynolds number, we predict that whether the flow type of the flow, it is a liquid, it is a laminar flow, or it is a transitional flow, or it is a turbulent flow. So three types of flows are there, which can be classified according to the Reynolds number. Then coming to the next point, that is taking the example of this one. For example, this wash basin is considered. In the wash basin, the cup is being placed, and then the flow of water is allowed to strike to the this particular cup, which means that from the tap the water is issued. And here you can see that these layers of the water, it is moving in a laminar flow and in a streamline flow. They are not mixing with the other layers of the water. However, here the splashing is taking place. So this kind of flow is nothing but the turbulent flow. And this is the what you are seeing vertically upward is nothing but the vertically downward is nothing but the laminar flow. So the laminar flow and turbulent flow, the summary we can take, that is layers of water flow over one another at different speeds and virtually no mixing between layer. The flow velocity profile for laminar flow in a circular pipe is parabolic in shape with a maximum flow in the center. And in turbulent flow, the flow is characterized by the irregular movement of particles of the fluid. The flow velocity of the turbulent flow is fairly flat across the center of a pipe and drops rapidly, extremely close to the wall. So viscosity term also we have studied in the first class. That is the fluid property that measures the resistance of a fluid to deforming due to a shear force. So for most fluid, the temperature and viscosity are inversely proportional. So the types of losses which occurs in a pipe whenever there is a flow of liquid is there. So what kind of losses are there? For example, the losses are classified as the minor losses and the major losses. So the major loss, you can see that it is due to the loss of heat due to friction, but the minor losses are due to the pipe fittings. For example, sudden enlargement, then the at the entrance, then due to the pipe fitting at the exit and the sudden contraction. Because there are several pipe fittings are there, like a bends are there, walls are there, all these things, sudden enlargement is there, sudden contraction is there at the entrance, even at the exit, the loss of energy, it takes place. So these losses are classified as the minor losses. So let us see the major loss. Loss of heat due to friction is termed as the major loss, and it depends on the velocity of flow, diameter of pipe and roughness. So it is denoted as HF. So HF is equal to FL V square by 2GD. So what is the V? V is nothing but the velocity of flow. D is nothing but the diameter of the pipe through which the flow is there. And G is acceleration due to gravity. F is your coefficient of friction, and L is nothing but the length of cross section of the pipe which is under consideration. And the minor losses, you can see that minor losses are due to this kind of sudden expansion or the contraction. Here you can see that this is the smaller diameter pipe which is being connected to the larger diameter pipe. Because of that, the eddy formation is there in this portion of the pipe, and then the losses are being taking place. So this HE is given by V1 minus V2 square divided by the 2G. So loss due to sudden enlargement. Similarly, loss due to sudden contraction. So if you consider this pipe, which is shown on your screen also on the top of the page, what you will see that this is the larger diameter pipe which is being connected to the smaller diameter pipe, and then because of that there is a sudden contraction is there. So this loss is denoted by HC, and SC is equal to 1 minus CC minus C1 square into V square by 2G. Similarly, the loss at the exit, here you can see one container. In the container, the water is allowed to flow into the container, and it is the head loss at the exit of the pipe. It is denoted by HEX is V square by 2G. These are nothing but the exit losses. Similarly, there are fittings like walls are there, couplings are there. So it is due to the pipe fittings like a elbow and wall. It is denoted by the HB, and HB is equal to K into V square divided by 2G. Okay. Similarly, not at the loss at the entrance, that is, it is head loss at the entrance of the pipe. It is denoted by HEN. Okay, so HEN is equal to 0.5 V square by 2G. So these are the loss due to the pipe fittings. Then the frictional losses in pipe, that is, it varies with the laminar or the turbulent flow. So the energy equation can be given as, all of you know that we have studied this energy equation also. That is the P1 by rho G plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 plus HA minus HR minus HL is equal to P2 by rho G plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2, which is nothing but the Bernoulli's equation also. So Bernoulli's theorem says that these are the equal one. Okay, this total energy at one point is equal to the total energy at the another point in a pipe. So where HA is equal to HA, HR and HL are the heads associated with the addition, removal and frictional loss in pipe respectively. So the head loss in pipes, HL, can be expressed by the Darcy-Bisbach equation or the Darcy's equation for energy loss. In the general form, it is 4F1 L1 V1 square divided by 2GD, where F is nothing but the friction factor, L is length of pipe, D is diameter of pipe, and V is the velocity of the pipe. Then the minor losses, that is, piping system includes fittings, wall bends, elbows, tees, inlets and exits, and enlargement and contractions. So these components interrupt the smooth flow of fluid and cause additional losses because of flow separation and mixing. The minor losses associated with this are nothing but HL is equal to KL into V square by 2G, where KL is the loss coefficient, okay, and it is different from the component and typically provided by the manufacturer, the value of the KL. Then the minor losses are expressed in terms of the loss coefficient KL. Here you can see that the delta PL is equal to delta P into P1 minus P2. So you can see that the wall is partially open. So when we close the wall, when we open the wall, accordingly, the energy losses will be there. So loss coefficient, such as the gate wall shows, is determining by measuring the pressure loss it causes and dividing it by the dynamic pressure in the pipe. So the total head loss in a system is comprised of major losses and the minor losses in the component. So what we can say that the loss of energy losses are nothing but the major loss plus minor loss. So major loss is your loss of head due to friction. Okay, taking the summation of this one, and in the entire piping system, it has a constant diameter, then HL is equal to FL by D summation of KL into V square by 2G. So the flow through the pipes in series. So pipes in series is defined as the pipe of different length and different diameter connected end to end to form a pipeline. And L1, L2, L3, these are nothing but the different lengths are there. Naturally, the diameters are different. So therefore, V1, V2, V3 are nothing but the different one. Velocities will be different. F1, F2, F3, coefficient of friction for the pipe. Okay. So here, the Q is equal to A1, V1 is equal to A2, V2 is equal to A3, V3. So this is the pipe which is connected in the series which is being shown. This is smaller diameter. It is connected to the larger diameter. And again, it is connected to the smaller diameter. So LA, LB, and this is the LC, last portion of the component. So pipe is divided into the three components, that is A, B, and C component. Okay, and then this is the QA, VA velocity will be there. This is diameter will be there, DB, okay, like that. Then the discharge through each pipe is same because flow of water, rate of flow of water, it will be same because Q is equal to rho 1 A1 V1 is equal to rho 2 A2 V2. So what is the value of rho? If the density remains constant, then rho 1 is equal to rho 2. So if the rho 1 is equal to rho 2, which means that Q is equal to A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2 is equal to A3 V3. So this is what suggested here. So the frictional loss through the pipeline are the sum of frictional loss of each pipe. So HL is equal to HF1 means head loss due to friction in the first section plus head loss due to friction in the second section plus head loss due to friction in the third section. Like that we keep on adding. And finally, what the equation we get is nothing but this is the applying the equation, that is a 4F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1 plus 4F2 L2 V2 square divided by 2G D2, like that. So this is the connection in series. Now connection in the parallel system, that is considering a main pipe which divide into more two or more branches. Okay, figure, I will be coming into the figure. In this case, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. So the frictional losses through all the pipes are same and all the pipes are discharge the water independently. So here HL is equal to HF1 is equal to HF2. In earlier case, we have added it. Okay, so 4F1 LV1 square divided by 2GD1 is equal to 4F2 LV2 square divided by 2GD2. So these are the connections in the series and connection in the pipe. Okay, in the series they are connected. Okay, and in the parallel when they are connected, that is Q1 is equal to Q2 is there. Okay, means total discharge is the sum of the discharge through the one pipe, one branch and the another branch. Similarly, the drawing the total energy line or the total gradient line. Now you can see that this is the tank and overhead tank, we can say that this is the available head. Okay, and if you can see that this pipe is there, larger diameter, smaller diameter, again larger diameter, having a length of L1, L2, L3, and the velocities are V1, V2, V3, they are connected in the series. Okay, and then we need to plot a hydraulic gradient line and a total energy line. So what is your hydraulic gradient line? Okay, so it is nothing but your here the total energy line. So this difference is nothing but the V square by 2G. In the total energy, we have added the kinetic energy component or velocity component also. Here the hydraulic gradient line is there. Okay, so with the help of this concept, we can find out the total energy gradient. So total energy gradient line is the equal to the sum of pressure head, velocity head and datum head. So EL is equal to H is equal to P by W plus V2, V2 square by 2G plus H is a constant. Okay, where EL is nothing but the energy line. So a turbine in the flow reduces the energy line and a pump or a fan in the line increases the energy line. Okay, so in the hydraulic gradient line is basically the sum of the pressure head and datum head. So HGL is equal to P by W plus H, where hydraulic gradient line lies one velocity head below the energy line. So calculating the power transmission through a pipe. So power can be transmitted by liquid which is flowing through pipe. So power transmission through pipe is commonly used to convey water from a high level reservoir to a turbine house and in operation of hydraulic equipment such as hydraulic press or crane or jack. So the power transmitted, it depends upon the weight of fluid flowing through a pipe and total head available at the end of the pipe. So P is equal to weight of water flowing through the pipe multiplied by the head available at the outlet of the pipe. So finally, P is given by rho AVG into capital H minus small h. Okay. So flow through nozzle at the end of the pipe, we have taken in earlier discussion the example of the fire brigade, wherein there is a flow of water through the nozzle. Okay, and in this case, how to calculate? So the function of the nozzle is to convert the total energy of liquid into a kinetic energy. So nozzle is used where higher velocity of liquid is required, as in case of the Pelton turbine or firefighting mining power developments. So since water is flowing continuously through a pipe and nozzle, we can apply the law of continuity, that is Q is equal to AV. Okay, so head at the inlet of nozzle is nothing but H minus HF, and head at the outlet of nozzle is equal to kinetic head V square by 2G. So according to the Bernoulli's equation, head at inlet is equal to head at outlet, neglecting the losses. So H minus HF is nothing but equal to the V square by 2G, because the head available at the nozzle, if you have seen in case of the jet of water which is being formed in case of Pelton turbine or in case of the your fire brigade where the nozzle is there, it is nothing but the kinetic head, that is V square by 2G. So H minus HF is equal to V square by 2G. Then solving this, we can get ultimately come up with the equation, that is V is equal to 2G capital H divided by 1 plus 4 FL A square divided by capital D A square. Okay, here the square root is there. So the condition for transmission of power through nozzle is similar to that of the pipe, that is HF is equal to H by 3. Then coming to the water hammer effects or the water hammer in pipe. So water while flowing in pipe possesses the momentum due to some velocity of water. If the flowing water is suddenly brought to rest by closing the valve, its momentum is destroyed, which causes a very high pressure waves. Now these high pressure waves will be transmitted along the pipe with a velocity equal to the velocity of sound wave. Okay, and it may create a noise which is called as knocking. Also, these waves are of high pressure, and it has the effect of hammering action on the walls of the pipe, thus known as water hammer effect. So there are three cases of water hammer depending upon the timetable in closing the valve. Okay, and they are the water hammer when valve is closed gradually, water hammer when the valve is suddenly closed and pipe is rigid, water hammer when the valve is suddenly closed and elastic pipe is there. For example, in case of the turbine application, you know that the whether it is a Pelton turbine, Francis turbine, the governing mechanism is there, because turbine is connected to the directly to the generator. अभी जो है अभी हमने लाइटिंग शुरू कर दी है. ओके, सभी लोग लाइट्स यूज कर रहे हैं क्योंकि अंधेरा हो गया है. सो नेचुरली दिस आर द पीक आवर्स. सो पीक आवर्स में क्या होगा, जनरेटर के ऊपर का जो लोड है वो बढ़ गया. तो व्हेन द जनरेटर के ऊपर का लोड अगर बढ़ गया है, सो नेचुरली द जनरेटर इज कपल्ड टू द टर्बाइन, हाइड्रोलिक टर्बाइन. सो द मोर क्वांटिटी ऑफ वाटर इज अलाउड टू फ्लो टुवर्ड द टर्बाइन, so that the power generated is more and it matches with the your load condition on the generator. Okay, after 10 pm if for example the load on the generator it get reduced, okay, because everybody is sleeping. Okay, now what I can say that the lights has been switched off, in that case the load will reduce. So when the load will reduce, again we have to decrease the quantity of water which is flowing toward the turbine. So which means that the valve which is being regulated by a governing mechanism in case of the hydel power station, it is continuously operating. Okay, it is regulating the flow of water toward the turbine. So when the gates of the turbines are suddenly closed, in that case what will happen, there is a suddenly the momentum of the flowing liquid, it is being destroyed. Because of that, the high pressure waves are generated, and these high pressure waves are equal to the velocity of the sound wave. Okay, 1000 times greater than that of the normal pressure waves. Thus it creates noise also, okay, which is called as the locking. At the same time, okay, the continuous generation of the high pressure waves is creates a water hammer effect. And if these waves are transmitted toward the turbine, or if it is transmitted toward the dam, in that case it may damage the dam. Damage may crack down, dam may crack down, and there are chances of accident. इसीलिए large hydropower station के installation में एक surge tank होती है. Surge tank मतलब क्या है, dam के और turbine के बीच में का अंतर ज्यादा होने की वजह से, okay, बीच में एक surge tank लगाई गई है जो टर्बाइन के पास लगाई जाती है, और जब हाई प्रेशर वेव्स जनरेट होते हैं तो वाटर हैमर इफेक्ट को वो जो सर्ज आता है, प्रेशर वेव्स जो आते हैं उसको वहीं पे ऊपर डैम्पन करके सर्ज टैंक में एब्जॉर्ब कर सकते हैं. अदरवाइज व्हाट विल हैपन इफ दीज हाई प्रेशर वेव्स आर ट्रांसमिटेड टुवर्ड द डैम ऑफ द टर्बाइन, इन दैट केस इट डैमेजेस द डैम, एंड देन डैमेज अगर डैम अगर हो गया तो उसका क्या परिणाम होता है ये आपको ऑलरेडी पता है. अपने महाराष्ट्र में भी ऐसे एक्सीडेंट्स हो गए हैं, 20,000-40,000 लोग जो है पूरे गांव के गांव बह के जाते हैं, एंड देर आर सो मेनी फ्लड सिचुएशन इज क्रिएटेड, आर्टिफिशियल फ्लड सिचुएशन व्हेन द डैम गेट्स क्रैक, एंड देन ऑल द फ्लॉटर विल ऑल द वॉटर इन द डैम इट फ्लशेस आउट एंड इट गोज वेर एवर इट फाइंड्स अ पाथ. And naturally, there is a damage to the fields as well as to the human being, those who are living nearby to the that dam area or toward the turbine area or the hydropower station. So, water hammer effect is likely to be there in turbine, but we have to minimize it by providing a surge tank, by regulating the flow of water, okay, by means of the governing mechanism in case of the turbine. So, these are the conditions of water hammer effect. It has been shown wall closed, water is still, wall is closed, so no pressure wave is there. Wall open, okay, it is flowing in the toward the light left to right direction. Now when the wall is closed suddenly, so what will happen, the back pressure will be created here, and these pressure waves, it creates a water hammer effect. So let us take some solved example, okay, and then we will move with the with our topic. So before going to the solved example, let me take a review that what we have studied till now. So can anybody tell me, Vedant, can anybody tell me that which topic we have studied right now? Beta Vedant, hello, can anybody tell me? Arpit Ramteke, Om, Shubham Chaure, अभिजीत मिश्रा, आदित्य कालक केलेकर, अथर्व सखदेव, यस सिद्धांत, सिद्धांत वॉज ऑनलाइन, यस कैन एनीबडी टेल मी व्हिच टॉपिक यू हैव कवर्ड टिल नाउ?
वाटर हैमर इन पाइप्स,
या बहुत देन तामगाड़के, यस प्लीज, हां यस तामगाड़के
सर, वी हैव स्टडीड लैमिनर फ्लो, टर्बुलेंट फ्लो, टाइप्स ऑफ लॉसेस,
हां
water hammer effect,
okay, very good, okay,
and
okay, very good, very good, okay. Then Pralay Meshram was also on the line, okay. Pralay,
water hammer in types,
Pralay, can you tell me that which topic we have covered,
sir? Water hammer in times type,
okay, okay. Can anybody tell me what do you mean by the major losses? मेजर लॉसेस क्या होते हैं?
हेड लॉस ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन सर.
अर्पित, हां अर्पित है, हां फ्रिक्शन, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड अर्पित, ओके, लॉस ऑफ हेड ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन, एंड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द माइनर लॉसेस?
सडन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन, सडन एनलार्जमेंट,
Yeah, due to the pipe fitting, sudden contraction, sudden enlargement, okay, it will be there. Okay, very good.
Okay.
So I will continue with the numericals again. So are you able to see my slides? Hello?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
So the sum of the solved example, that is a pipe 1 meter diameter and 15 kilometer long, transmits water at a velocity of 1 meter per second, and the friction coefficient of pipe is 0.005. Then in this case, you are asked to calculate the head loss due to friction. So head loss due to friction equation, which we have studied, 4FL V square by 2GD. So HF, by putting the values in this equation, we can calculate 15.29 meter. Similarly, this is the pipe in which it is connected in series. So pipe of 40 meter long is connected to a water tank at one end and flows freely, okay, freely in the atmosphere.
Screen is not visible.
Okay, let me check.
Screen there. Okay.
Is it visible now? Yes.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Screen is not.
Yes,
visible.
Sir. Yes. Now visible.
Yes, sir. Okay. So pipe of 40 meter long is connected to a water tank at one end and flows freely in atmosphere at other end. The diameter of pipe is 15 centimeter for the first 25 meter. Okay. From the tank, and then the diameter is suddenly enlarged. Ye jo dikh raha hai wo, suddenly enlarged to 30 centimeter. The height of water tank, water in the tank, it is 8 meter above the center of the pipe, and Darcy's coefficient is given 0.01. So determine the discharge, neglecting the minor losses, means loss of head due to entrance, loss of head due to exit, and loss of head due to sudden enlargement. This we have to neglect. So loss of head, loss due to friction is basically, these are connected in series. So HF1 plus HF2, loss of head in pipe 1 and loss of head due to friction in pipe 2. So applying our equation, what we can find out, the discharge is equal to 0.087 meter cube per second. Similarly, this is the another example which I am taking, wherein the two pipes are connected in parallel between two reservoirs that have difference in levels 3.5 meter. Yahan pe parallel connection hai aur difference in water level jo hai wo 3.5 meter hai. The length, the diameter and friction factor 4F are 2400 meter, 1.2 meter, and friction factor 4F is given by the 0.026. Try to understand that value of 4F is given here, 0.026 for the first pipe and for the second pipe. So calculate the total discharge between the two reservoir. Now you know that HL is equal to, this equation is there, okay. Then calculating the value of Q1, okay. Similarly, calculating the value of Q2, and these two pipes are connected in parallel. So in parallel, what will happen? Total discharge is nothing but the summation of the discharge through pipe 1 plus summation of the discharge through pipe 2. So it is 1.29 plus 0.96 is equal to 2.25 meter cube per second. Okay. Now let us see the sum of the previous year gate question. That is, what is the correct formula for loss of head at the exit of a pipe? Now the it is your turn. You have to answer. Okay. Which answer is correct? We have studied the formula for the loss of head due to loss of energy or loss of head at the exit of a pipe. Can anybody tell me? Hello? Hello? So here, the answer B is correct, that is HL is equal to V square by 2G. So what is Darcy-Weisbach formula for heat loss due to friction, where Darcy's coefficient of friction is equal to, that is, these values are given. So it is nothing but the HF is equal to 4FL V square by 2GD. Okay. Minor losses do not make any serious effect in short pipe, long pipes, or both the short as well as long pipes. Up cannot say. These are the previous year gate examination. So minor losses are can be neglected in case of the long pipes. Okay. So it does not have the serious effects in long pipe. What is the formula for determining the size of an equivalent pipe for two pipes of lengths L1, L2 and diameters D1, D2 respectively? So here L is equal to L1, L2. So what we can see is that the equivalent diameter equation that we can derive and we can find out, that is L by D to the power of 5 is equal to L1 D1 to the power of 5 plus L2 D to the power of 5. This option is correct. So the highest point of siphon is called as, okay, siphon top, summit, reservoir, or none of the above. So siphon action or siphon, okay, siphon, regarding the siphon or its action, I can tell you this terminology is being used in case of the turbines also, okay, or spillway siphon in case of the dam and turbine. Okay. And while removing the water from the water cooler, removing the water from the water cooler, you can see that how we remove it. Okay, tank mein se agar pani nikalna hai, what we can do is that here the siphon action is there. Insert of one end of the pipe inside the tank, okay, and then allow the water to flow from the another end. Another end is at the lower end, okay. But what will happen? Agar aap tank mein pipe dalte hai, to uska end niche pe hai, aur bina kisi pump lagaye hue, wo pani tank ki jo height hai, wahan tak ke flow hota hai, aur uske baad mein pura pani wo nikalte jata hai, without using the any kind of pump, okay. So hum log jo कूलर को खाली करते हैं तो वहां पे जो पानी निकालते हैं बेसिकली इट इज अ सिफॉन एक्शन व्हिच इज बीइंग टेकिंग प्लेस. सो सेम थिंग आर सेम फंडामेंटल्स आर बीइंग अप्लाइड इन केस ऑफ द हाइड्रोलिक टर्बाइन. सो दैट हाईएस्ट पॉइंट ऑफ द सिफॉन इज बेसिकली कॉल्ड एज द समिट. देन व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ चेंज इन रेनॉल्ड नंबर ऑन फ्रिक्शन फैक्टर इन टर्बुलेंट फ्लो? Okay, so answer is, as the Reynolds number increases, friction factor in turbulent flow, okay, friction factor in turbulent flow, it increases. Okay, so friction factor also decreases in the, as the Reynolds number increases, the friction factor, it decreases in case of the turbulent flow. So the friction factor in fuel flowing through pipe depends upon what? Okay, Reynolds number pe depend hota hai friction factor. Yeah, relative roughness of the pipe surface. So it is basically depends on both option A and option B. The head loss through fluid flowing pipe due to friction is the basically the major head loss. Okay, so loss of head due to friction is nothing but the major head loss. Then this is the equation, that is for a fluid fluid flow through a divergent pipe of length L having inlet and outlet radii of R1 and R2 respectively, and a constant flow rate of Q, assuming the velocity to be axial and uniform at any cross section, the acceleration at the exit is, okay, gate 2004, it is of 2 mark. So option is nothing but 2Q square in bracket R1 minus R2 divided by pi square LR 2 to the power of 5. Similarly, water at 25 degrees centigrade is flowing through a 1 kilometer long GI pipe of 200 mm diameter at the rate of 0.07 meter cube per second. Okay, if value of Darcy friction factor for this pipe is 0.02 and density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube, the pumping power in kilowatt is required to maintain the flow. Okay, is so equation we have studied, so it comes out to be 17.4 kilowatt. So consider this is the GATE 2009 examination question, for which was asked for the 2 mark. That is, considered a steady flow of water in a situation where the two pipelines, pipe 1 and pipe 2, combine into a single pipeline, okay, and the cross-sectional area of all three pipelines are constant. Matlab kaise cross-sectional area tino pipe ka constant hai, but yahan pe two branches are leading toward the only one pipe. So pipe 1 area is 1 meter square, velocity is 1. Pipe 2, this is pipe 2, you have that is area 2 meter square, velocity is 2. Okay, then pipe 3, area is 2.5, velocity is we have to calculate. So by applying the equation, we can assuming the water properties and the velocities to be uniform across the cross section of the inlet and outlet, the exit velocity in meter per second in pipe 3, pipe 3 mein calculate kar raha hai, so it is coming out to be 2 meter per second. So for a steady fully developed flow inside a straight pipe of diameter D neglecting gravity effects, the pressure drop delta P over a length L and the wall shear stress TW are related by, okay, so this was a 2013 question. That is A is equal to TW divided by delta PD divided by 4L. So with this, I conclude with this topic of flow through pipe, and then I will start with the another topic now. So let me check that whether you have any type of questions, okay, or the what type of let me ask some question that which topic we have covered now. Okay. Can anybody answer? Hello? In this section, which what we have considered? Hello? Are you Amrit Rai, Arpit Ramteke? Okay. Arpit Ramteke, Amrit Rai, Shubham Chavre, Nikesh Pandre. Om, Nikesh, anybody is here? Are you listening to me?
Sir, liquid through pipes?
Ha, Nikesh, ha, yes. Yes, Nikesh, please, ha. बोलो निकेश
सर, लिक्विड थ्रू पाइप्स विद,
हां फ्लो थ्रू पाइप तो पढ़ा ही हमने अभी, जो सेकंड पार्ट में पढ़ा. ओके, व्हिच टाइप ऑफ टू कनेक्शंस वी हैव स्टडी फॉर अ पाइप, हाउ दे कैन बी कनेक्टेड, इन व्हिच टू पॉसिबल कनेक्शंस आर देयर.
पैरेलल एंड सीरीज,
या पैरेलल कनेक्शन, वेरी गुड तामगाड़गे. Parallel connection and the series connection. Okay, and then we have studied the formulas, also we have studied the equations. Okay, so thank you very much. Be on the line. I will start with my second part of the presentation regarding the impulse turbine. Then let me check, okay, whether it is visible to you or not. Is it visible to you? My screen is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you, thank you, thank you. So definitions of the turbo machine. Basically, turbines are energy developing device. You know that the turbines, it converts the fluid energy into the mechanical energy. So the mechanical energy developed by the turbine is used in running an electric generator, which is directly coupled to the shaft of the electric generator. So turbines, earlier days, it was made up of the wooden wheels, okay? And nowadays, the metal or the turbine, metallic turbines are there, hydraulic turbines. The turbines has become modernized in last 4-5 decades, and very high and efficient turbines are used in case of the hydropower station. So there are two types of turbines. Basically, we classified it as a impulse turbine and the reaction turbine. Okay, impulse hydraulic turbine and the reaction hydraulic turbine. So in the example of the impulse turbine, the example is nothing but the Pelton turbine. And in case of the reaction turbine, the Kaplan turbine or the Francis turbine, these are the examples of the basically the reaction turbine. So in today's topic of our presentation, we are going to study the impulse turbine only, not the reaction turbine. So the overshot wheel is there. So it has a very good efficiency, could not handle large quantity of wheels, quantity of water. And undershot wheel, it has a low efficiency. So general layout of a hydroelectric power plant, in the general layout, what we can say that the reservoir is there. Okay, reservoir ensures the supply of water throughout the year by storing water during a rainy season and supplying the same during the dry season. So naturally, reservoir is being required. So like a dam is to be constructed, and in the general layout of a hydroelectric power plant, a dam is required. So what is the function of the dam? The function of the dam is to increase the reservoir capacity and to increase the working head of the turbine. Okay, dam ki height jitni hongi, ya dam jitni height pe honga, jitna storage badhayega, uske hisab se turbine jis head ke under kaam karta hai, wo uska head decide hoga. So you know that the straight away line of demarcation is not there, but according to the turbines are also classified according to the head available, and it is high head turbine, medium head turbine, and the low head turbine. Pelton turbine or impulse turbine is an example of the high head turbine. Then the penstock. So what do we mean by the penstock? A pipe between dam and turbine is known as the penstock. So it will carry the water from the dam to the turbine. So penstock is commonly made of steel pipes connected with, covered with the RCC. Because the fluid with the high pressure from the dam, it flows through the penstock. So therefore, this steel pipe should not break up, or it should not get damaged because of the high pressure of the liquid. Therefore, it is being covered with the RCC, and that pipes are called as the penstock in the layout of the hydroelectric power plant. Then the surge tank or forebay. When the rate of water flow through the penstock is suddenly decreased, the pressure inside the penstock will increase suddenly due to water hammer and thereby damage the penstock or the surge tank. And forebay is constructed between the dam and the turbine. Okay, it will act as a pressure regulator during the variable load. So just now we have studied that. Yes, in the large installation of the hydroelectric power plant, where the distance between the dam and the turbine, it is very large, maybe greater than 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, like that. In that case, the surge tank is very essential. It is necessary in case of the hydro power station. So therefore, surge tank, what we can say that it is again the like a temporary storage of the water. It is nearer to the turbine. And these gates of the turbine, these are not constant. Okay, it is fluctuating in the sense. Okay, jitna load of generator ke upar hai, uske according quantity of water should be allowed to flow toward the turbine. So the turbine gates, what we can say that it is being actuated according to the load onto the generator. So therefore, quantity of flow of water or the rate of flow of water, it should be governed with the help of the governing mechanism. And when the valves of the turbines are closed suddenly, or valves are closed, there is a water hammer effect. And you know that in the water hammer effect, there is a high pressure waves are generated, and these high pressure waves, they can be transmitted toward the dam. और अगर डैम की तरफ अगर गए तो इन दैट केस इट डैमेजेस द डैम एंड इट कॉजेस द डैम टू ब्रेक एंड फर्दर इट मे लीड टू द एक्सीडेंट. सो देयरफॉर द सर्च टैंक्स आर बीइंग यूज्ड इन सच एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ द हाइड्रल पावर स्टेशन. सो टर्बाइंस इट कन्वर्ट द काइनेटिक एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑफ वाटर इन टू द मैकेनिकल एनर्जी टू प्रोड्यूस द इलेक्ट्रिक पावर. That is nothing but the hydraulic turbine. And a generator and a transformer, a electric generator converts mechanical energy into electric energy. A setup transformer will increase the voltage for loss-free transmission. So this is the layout of the general layout of the hydraulic power station. So you can see here, this is a river reservoir. Okay, here the dam is being constructed, and then the through this penstock you can see that the water is allowed to flow. Okay, either the in underground hydraulic power plant are also there. क्योंकि ये head मिलने के लिए हमें क्या किया है, river के ऊपर dam create किया है. And then एट द बॉटम लेवल, मतलब ये इंक्लाइन पाइपलाइन देखे, यहाँ पे टर्बाइन इंस्टॉल किया गया. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द डाउन स्ट्रीम साइड ऑफ द हाइड्रल पावर स्टेशन विच इज नथिंग बट कॉल्ड एज द टेलरेस लेवल. ओके, दिस इज मीडियम हेड पावर प्लांट. हियर यू कैन सी द ड्राफ्ट ट्यूब इज देयर. सो ड्राफ्ट ट्यूब इज यूज इन केस ऑफ द फ्रांसिस टर्बाइन or the reaction turbine. So this is the Francis turbine which is being shown. This is the powerhouse. Okay, inlet valve, penstock. This is your surge tank or forebay. Okay, so that the temporary storage is there, and this is the inlet valve. Okay, and this is the dam. So this is the general layout of a hydroelectric power plant. So what are the advantages of hydroelectric power plant? That is, the operating cost is very low. Okay, less maintenance cost and less manpower is required. It's a pollution free. You know that if you use the nuclear power plant, naturally the nuclear power plant, the radioactive elements are hazardous, and it creates a pollution problem. Handling the radioactive element, it is very difficult one. Similarly, if you use the thermal power plant, coal is to be burned. In that case, again, the lot of pollution is there. So the hydroelectric power plant, these are basically pollution-free power plants are there. They are quick to start and easy to synchronize, can be used for irrigation and flood control, and long plant life is there in case of the hydel power station. The disadvantages of the hydel power station: initial cost of total plant is comparatively high. Okay, because lot of area you need to be covered for the dam. Okay, in order to create a reservoir, lot of area is to be covered, and rehabilitation plan of the people, those who are residing in the villages nearer to the river or nearer to the dam or the hydel power station, it is being required. So the initial cost of the total plant is comparatively higher compared with the thermal power plant. So power generation depends on the availability of the water. So naturally, it is totally depend upon the quantity of water which is available, rate of flow of water which is available, and the catchment area. In that catchment area, how much rainfall is there, how much quantity of water can be collected, accordingly power generation will be there. So basically, in the hydel power station, power generation, it depends upon the availability of water. So the cost of transmission is high, since most of the plants are in remote areas. Okay, And then the project duration, it is long. It takes a lot of time for the construction and all. So these are the disadvantages of the hydroelectric power station. Now let us see that what are the efficiencies or the gross head, that is difference between the headless level and the tailless level. Okay, that is static head, no water flow is there, total head is H1. Net head or effective head, so head available at the entrance of the turbine is nothing but H is equal to H1 minus HF. What is HF? HF is nothing but head loss due to friction. So total head available for the turbine, it is nothing but H1 minus HF. So net head for a reaction turbine, for a Francis turbine, is nothing but P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 minus Z2 plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. And net head for impulse turbine is P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 minus Z2. So hydraulic efficiency, due to hydraulic losses, the power developed by the runner, that is net power supplied to the turbine entrance in kilowatt, and the power, that is water power, WHP. So hydraulic efficiency is nothing but the your power developed by the runner. Okay, mechanical power is available at the runner, and what is the power supplied? Input is nothing but the hydraulic power. Okay, water, it contains hydraulic power, that is W into Q into H. Okay, so WQH in kilowatt, it is nothing but your input, and the power developed by the runner is output, which gives you the hydraulic efficiency of a turbine. Then due to the mechanical losses, that is power available at the turbine shaft divided by the power developed by the runner, that is nothing but your mechanical efficiency. Then what do we mean by the volumetric efficiency of a hydraulic turbine? Due to amount of water slips directly to the tail rest, the amount of water striking to the runner, okay, divided by the amount of water supplied to the turbine. Matlab, kuch quantity of water directly tail rest level pe chala jata hai, and it slips to the tail rest level. Because of that, the actual quantity of water striking to the runner of the turbine is lesser than what we have supplied to the turbine. So therefore, it is calculated as a volumetric efficiency of a turbine. And the overall efficiency of a turbine is nothing but power available at the turbine shaft divided by net power supplied at the turbine entrance. So turbines are classified according to the several consideration as indicated below, that is based on the working principle, impulse turbine and the reaction turbine. So hydraulic turbines are classified as impulse turbine, reaction turbine. In the impulse turbine, the Pelton wheel, turbo wheel, then the cross flow turbine, these are the examples of the impulse turbine. Similarly, reaction turbine, propeller turbine, Francis turbine, okay, in the propeller turbine, flex blade, Kaplan turbine, tubular turbine, or the bulb turbine. These are the various types of turbine, and they are classified according to the working principle as impulse turbine and reaction turbine. So what do you mean by the impulse turbine? The pressure of liquid does not change while flowing through the rotor of the machine. Okay, that is nothing but the impulse turbine. So impulse turbine, the pressure change occur only in the nozzle of the machine. So one of such example of the impulse turbine is basically the Pelton wheel or Pelton turbine. And the reaction turbine, the pressure of liquid changes while it flows through the rotor of the machine. The change in fluid velocity and reduction in its pressure causes a reaction on the turbine blade. This is where from the name reaction turbine may be derived. So Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine, they fall under the category of the reaction turbine. Now the classification based on the working media, that is hydraulic turbine, steam turbine, gas turbine, and wind turbine. So now we are dealing with the hydraulic turbine. Then based on the head, that is head is the elevation difference of reservoir water level, okay, and the downstream side of water level. So if it is above 250 meter, it is called as the high head turbine. If it is in the range of 62 to 50 meter, it is a Francis turbine. And if it is below 60 meter, it is a Kaplan turbine. Try to remember the these ranges. So above high head turbine example is nothing but the Pelton turbine. 62 to 50 meter means a Francis turbine, and below 60 meter is a Kaplan turbine. So which means that, okay, even if the small dam is there and the head of the water available it is lesser than 60 meter, the Kaplan turbine can be used. If it is more like a Bhakra Nangal dam or like a nearer to Nagpur Totara dam is there. So in such cases, if the high head is available, then the Pelton turbine it is being used above 250 meters. So based on the specific speed, so turbine can be classified based on the specific speed. So specific speed, what do you mean by the specific speed? Specific speed is defined as the speed in RPM, revolution per minute, of a geometrically similar turbine, which is identical in shape, dimensions, blade angle, and gate openings with the actual turbine working under unit head and developing unit power. So specific speed is used to compare the turbine and is denoted by the NS. So specific speed is equal to NS is equal to N root of P divided by H to the power of 5 by 4. So low specific speed, high head means low specific speed. क्योंकि यहाँ पे देखिए N root of P H to the power of 5 by 4. So that is Pelton turbine. When the specific speed is medium, 50 to 350, it is a Francis turbine. When the high specific speed is there, 250 to 860, it is a Kaplan turbine. Then based on the disposition of turbine main shaft, the turbines are classified as the horizontal shaft or the vertical shaft turbine also. Okay, based on the flow of runner water or flow of liquid through the runner, it is called as the radial flow turbine, that is inward radial flow or outward radial flow. So axial flow turbine, the flow of water is there along the axis of the turbine. So axial flow turbine, basically Kaplan turbine. Okay, mixed flow turbine, that is a Francis turbine. Here the entry is axial and exit is in the outward direction. So it is a mixed flow turbine. Tangential flow turbine is nothing but the Pelton turbine. Now you are seeing a example of the Pelton turbine. You can see that it has a circular disc with cup-shaped blades and bucket. So these are the cup-shaped blades and bucket. So water jet emerging from a nozzle is tangential to the circumferential of the wheel. मतलब इस direction में अगर है, so the water jet it is tangential to the circumference of the wheel. Okay, so this is nothing but your Pelton turbine. So water jet emerging strike the bucket at the splitter. Okay, अभी जो यहाँ पे देखा था आपने, okay, ये splitter portion है. The bucket is separated into two parts. So basically this portion is nothing but the splitter. It splits into the two part. Okay, so the stream flow along the inner core of the bucket and leave it in the direction opposite to that of the incoming jet. The high pressure water can be obtained from any water body situated at some height or streams of water flowing down the hill. The change in momentum of water stream produces an impulse on the blades of the wheel of turbine, Pelton turbine. This impulse generates the torque and rotation in the shaft of the Pelton turbine. So horizontal shaft, not more than two jets are used. Vertical shaft, larger number of jets up to six can be used. Iron steel casing used to prevent splashing of water or to lead the water toward the tail rest. So you know that the buckets of the turbine are hauled into the two part with the help of the splitter. Basically, when the jet of water is strikes onto the splitter, it splits into the two parts. Okay, and it neutralizes the axial thrust which is being acting into the bearing. So therefore, its use is there, its application is there, and it is beneficial to to have instead of having a single bucket, having the bucket and splitting it into the two part, two hemispherical shape, and then the angle also, the cut section is also, you can see that, okay, because what happens, okay, the outgoing jet of water, if it strikes to the next incoming bucket, then it will exert a retarding motion onto the Pelton turbine. So therefore, the buckets are having the outward jet which is striking to, after leaving the bucket. Okay, here it is being cut section. It is being shown over there. So this cut section you can see in this picture. So this is to avoid the retarding motion. So it uses the velocity of the water to move the runner and discharges to the atmospheric pressure. The water stream hits each bucket on the runner. So no suction downside, water flows through the turbine housing after heating. So high head flow, low application. Types of turbine are nothing but the Pelton turbine and the cross flow turbine. So this is the velocity triangle for a Pelton turbine. You can see that the velocity triangle for a Pelton turbine. Yeah, this is the bucket. Single bucket is shown. Now these are the two hemispherical shape. Okay, but this is the point of splitter. A jet of water is striking onto the splitter. Okay, this velocity V1 is equal to VW1, okay, and this is U1 plus here VR1, and then the jet of water, it is not deflected through the 180 degree. If it is deflected through the angle of deflection is 180 degree, then what will happen? The outgoing jet will strike to the back of the incoming bucket and it exert a retarding pressure, retarding motion onto the runner of the wheel or the Pelton wheel. So therefore, this angle of deflection is being provided. So what you can see that this is the VR1. Now this component is nothing but the VR2, that is relative velocity at the exit of the turbine. And this component is nothing but your V2, absolute velocity at outlet. Here the V1 is equal to VW1. यहाँ पे inclined है, so what will happen? We resolve this into the vertical component and horizontal component. So vertical component of the absolute velocity of the water at exit is nothing but the Vf2, which is called as the flow velocity. Okay, and this horizontal component of the absolute velocity, it is called as the velocity of whirl, that is VW2. And this component of velocity is nothing but the U2, that is peripheral velocity of the runner. Okay, and this component is nothing but U1. So V1 is absolute velocity of water as inlet, VR1 jet velocity, that is relative velocity to the at inlet, here alpha angle between the direction of the jet, and at the direction of the motion of the vane, theta is vane angle at outlet, VW1, whirl velocity at inlet, VF1 flow velocity, V2 is outlet velocity of the jet, VF2 is outlet flow velocity, similarly VR2 is outlet jet velocity relative to vane, V and phi outlet velocity triangle, okay, from the inlet and outlet velocity triangle, then we find out. And then finally, we get an equation for force exerted by a jet of water in the direction of motion, which is given by F is equal to rho A V1 in bracket VW1 plus VW2. Okay, then calculating the net work done by jet on a runner per second. So F is into U mu is in bracket rho A V1 in bracket VW1 plus VW2 into U. Okay, so finally, efficiency of a hydraulic turbine, that is work done per second, is the output divided by kinetic energy of jet. Pelton turbine may energy possessed by the fluid at inlet is nothing but the kinetic energy. So therefore, efficiency of hydraulic turbine can be calculated. And finally, we come up with the equation, that is NH is equal to 2 in bracket V1 plus K in V minus U into cos of phi minus U into U divided by V1 square. So the hydraulic efficiency will be maximum for a given value of V1. Okay. So from the inlet and outlet triangle, we can calculate the hydraulic efficiency of a turbine. And similarly, this equation is being derived. So the equation state that the hydraulic efficiency of a Pelton turbine is maximum when the velocity of wheel is half the velocity of jet at water at inlet, okay, the maximum. Therefore, the here, the if the friction factor K is equal to 1, it is being given by NH is equal to maximum in bracket 1 plus cos of phi divided by 2. And hydraulic efficiency is equal to maximum efficiency 1 plus K cos of phi divided by 2. So one example is being taken here, that is a Pelton turbine having a bucket diameter of 1 meter and running at 1000 RPM. A head is given, that is 700 meter, phi is 15 degree and Q is equal to 1 meter cube per second. So find the power available and the hydraulic efficiency. So power available, that is rho g into q into h. So putting the values in this equation, we can calculate the power available, that is 18.6, 86.71. similarly, calculate the velocity also. V1 is equal to cv into 2gh. So and then finally u1 is equal to 52.31. so hydraulic efficiency of a turbine, it comes out to be, by putting in this equation, that is 2 in bracket V1 minus U multiplied by 1 plus cos of phi into U divided by V1 square. So finally it comes out to be 97.17%. Okay. So this is the definition of a turbo machine. That is a turbine wheel is being shown here. Nozzle direct forceful streams of water against a series of spoon-shaped bucket mounted around the edge of the wheel. This is the shaft of the turbine, and you can see that there are series of bucket which is being mounted onto the runner of the turbine. Each bucket reverses the flow of water, and this impulse spins the turbine. So this is the Pelton wheel, which was developed in 1593, which you can see that. Okay, this type of wheel is there. Even you can experiment at home to find out the Pelton, to prepare the Pelton turbine. Okay, here the jet of water is there. So suited for high head, low flow side. The largest units can be up to 200 megawatt. It can operate with a head as small as 15 meter and head as high as 1800 meters also. Okay, so you can imagine the size of the basically the turbine. Okay, so I will stop here and let me take a review that what we have covered today, so that we can move further again, and then we will end up. Okay, so yes. Yes. So can anybody tell me which topic we have covered just now? Yes, anyone from the student? Rushi Hamne.
Sir, hydraulic dam.
Shubham Chaure. Yes, Shubham. Yes, hydraulic dam.
Sir, hydraulic dams, its limitation, classification, advantages, disadvantages. Disadvantages and types of flow meters.
Okay. Very good, Shubham. Okay, so we have studied the hydraulic dam, means general layout of the hydel power station. We have studied classification of the turbines. We have studied also the Pelton turbine. We have studied impulse turbine, and then we have also studied the velocity triangle. How to draw a velocity triangle, horizontal component, vertical component, like that. and also we have covered one example of the calculating the efficiency of the turbine. So let me ask you the next question, that is, what is the classification of the turbine according to the head? According to the head, how the turbines are classified? So Akash is there, Abhijit Mishra is there. Can Abhijit answer the question? Akash Bhavankar is there. Akash Bhavankar, Abhijit, Akshay Srirame. Akshay, repeating the question.
Hello.
Yes, Arpit Ramteki is online. So Arpit, can you tell me what are the classification of the turbine according to the head available?
Based on head, sir,
high head turbine. Yes, you are on the
high head turbine.
Okay, very good.
About 250 meter.
Yes, above around 250, 260 we can say. High head turbine, yes. Very good, Arpit. Next.
Medium head is 60 to 250 meter.
Yes, medium head turbine.
And okay. And low head turbine below 60 meter.
60 meter, very good, very good. Very good, Arpit. Can anybody give the example of the high head turbine, medium head turbine and the low head turbine? Abhijit Mishra. Yes. Yes, Abhijit.
The example of high head turbine is Pelton turbine and it is about 250
okay,
meters.
Okay, very good, Abhijit.
Francis turbine is the medium head turbine and it is range is 60 meter to 250 meter.
Okay, very good. Okay.
And third one is the Kaplan turbine. It was the low head turbine and it is below the 60 meters range.
Okay, very good. Very good, Abhijit. Okay, so next question to you is that anybody can answer, including Sumit Padole also, Tushar Raut also. So why the buckets of the turbine are split into the two parts? What is the reason? Okay, buckets of the Pelton turbine are split into the two parts. Splitter is there. It splits the jet of water into the two part. Why it is being done like that? Vinay Patle, anybody? Vipul Bin, can you answer my question? Yes, anyone?
Sir,
is there? Arpit. Yes, Arpit, please.
Because of axial thrust.
Yes, because of what happens, that axial thrust will be generated if there it is made into the single part. Okay, and then because of that, the bearings have to sustain the axial thrust. Okay, runner of the turbine, it is mounted into the that shaft is mounted into the basically the bearings only. So therefore, the splitter, it splits the jet of water into the two part, and then it is made into the two parts so as to neutralize the axial thrust in both the cups. Okay, then why the outgoing jet is not deflected, through an angle of 180 degree. Okay, bucket ko ek to cut section hota hai aur wo jo angle of deflection jo hai wo 180 degree mein nahi kiya gaya hai Pelton turbine ke buckets mein. Aisa kyun? Can Harsh Pandey answer my question? Indra Kumar, can you answer my question? Kalyani Satadeve,
sir, can you answer? Sir, if 180 degree mein,
yes,
180 degree mein agar wo reverse jet jo hai wo 180 degree mein aayega to wo next jo Pelton wheel ka wheel jo aa raha hai Pelton wheel ka plate us pe wo strike hoga aur uski velocity ko restrict karega.
Okay, very good Indra Kumar. So what will happen if the jet of water is deflected through an 180 degree? Okay, in that case, the maximum utilization of the flow will be there. Energy of flow will be there. But if it is deflected through the 180 degree, in that case, the outgoing jet from the earlier previous bucket, it will strike to the back of the incoming bucket. And because of that, the retarding motion onto the runner of the wheel will be there. So in order to avoid this retarding motion, basically the turbine angle is being decided and the angle is being kept, maybe 165 degree or 160 degree, like that. Okay. So this kind of topics which we have studied right now, also we have studied the efficiency of the turbine. So let me go to the last part of the presentation. Then again, I will come back to you, okay, so that we can again take a concluding remarks of the presentation. So let me present. So are you able to see my screen? Yes, screen is visible. Hello? Can anyone tell me that?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay, thank you, thank you. So purely multi-stage impulse turbines are mainly prepared in medium capacity for power generation, that is a 30 to 60 megawatt unit. So the main advantage are the simplicity of construction, low cost and reliability and convenience of operation. The height of blades in large stages of multi-stage turbine rapidly increase. Okay, it is difficult to obtain tall, smooth and streamlined shape for the turbine. The turbines of compound impulse stages are considered absolute at present. And it is the current practice of multi-stage turbine to allow for some amount enthalpy drop to take place in the moving blade as well. So I will stop my presentation here. So thank you very much. And then we will go back to our discussion. Okay. And then we will conclude today's topic, as well as my presentation from my topics. It is over. I have covered the fluid power and the hydraulic machinery. Okay. So what is the function of the surge tank in a hydraulic power station? What is the function of surge tank in a hydraulic power station? Can anybody answer? Sumit Padore?
Hello, sir.
Abhijit is there on the line. Yes, Abhijit.
Surge tank is constructed between dam and turbine, and it will act as a pressure regulator.
Okay, very good. Very good, Abhijit. Very good. What do you mean by the water hammer effect, and why water hammer effect occurs basically? Vipul, can you answer? Can anybody answer? What do you mean by the water hammer effect, and why water hammer effect it basically occurs? Yes, Atharva Sakhdev is there. Anyone? Nitin Wadai, Nitin, are you here? Nitin, Akash? Yes, Shubham Chavri is there. Yes, Shubham.
Sir, by rapid stopping of flow.
By rapid stopping of flow. Yes, you are right. Okay. Yes, you are right. Please continue.
While the pressure is upstream.
When the flow of water. When the flow of liquid is there and its momentum is suddenly destroyed by closing the valve, then there will be a generation of the high pressure waves. Okay, so this effect is called as the water hammer effect. Okay, Shubham, chalo, very good. Okay,
yes, sir.
So, any question, Vishwajit, from my side, it is over. Okay, already 8:15 is there, 8:15, 8:20. So, any questions are there, we will take up the question.
If any students having any question, kindly ask to Honorable Dr. G.K. Awari, sir. Students, you have any question regarding today's topic? Sir, I think that now student didn't have any problem regarding.
Yes. Okay. Akash is there. On the line. Yes, Akash.
Yes, sir. My time turbine is matlab sir jab work लगता है दैट मिसिंग में
आकाश आवाज नहीं आ रही
फंक्शन क्या इससे होता है
हेलो
अच्छा हेलो
आकाश तुम्हारी आवाज क्लियर नहीं आ रही है आकाश
आकाश बेटा आपकी आवाज
नहीं आ रही
थोड़ा रेंज
नहीं तो चैट बॉक्स में भी क्वेश्चंस डाल सकते हैं चैट बॉक्स में हाँ वॉइस ब्रेक हो रहा है आपका आकाश
आकाश आपका वॉइस ब्रेक हो रहा है आप चैट बॉक्स में अपना क्वेश्चन टाइप कीजिए
any question that you can type in the chat box if you are not able to connect so that we can take up for the discussion
Akash you are typing there or not hello Akash sir I think that on that yes, side sir. Some network problem is there
yes.
Akash, yes, I think he is typing the question. Another one that the remaining topics in the hydraulic turbine, that is a Pelt Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine is there. Yes, Arpit, Arpit is online. Okay, Arpit, sir, any question?
Sir, basic difference, impulse and reaction turbine.
In the basic difference between the impulse and the reaction turbine is that. In the impulse turbine, the available energy, hydraulic energy, it is nothing but the kinetic energy. Okay, because the nozzle is used in case of the impulse turbine, and this nozzle it converts the pressure energy into the kinetic energy. Okay, and then the jet of water is formed, and then it is strikes to the turbine. So in impulse turbine. Basic difference basically the pressure available means the energy available it is nothing but the kinetic energy at the entrance of the turbine whereas in case of the Francis turbine okay or the reaction turbine the conversion of the pressure energy into the kinetic energy it is being taking place inside the runner of the turbine okay isliye in case of the Pelton turbine okay housing purpose of the housing is that okay Pelton ki housing use karte hain it to avoid the splashing of the water it does not play any role in defining the efficiency of the turbine in case of the Pelton however in case of the reaction turbine it is having a role turbine casing is also having a role in the efficiency of the turbine okay so therefore okay the in case of the impulse turbine the kinetic energy is there in case of the reaction turbine the energy available at the inlet of the turbine is nothing but the pressure energy so this is the basic difference between the impulse hydraulic turbine and the reaction hydraulic turbine okay Arpit
thank you
any other question from anybody else
sir
Akash has asked the question in that of Pelton turbine for casing is work performed and hydraulic function is yes or not no there is no hydraulic function to the casing of Pelton turbine okay hydraulic function means it does not play role in defining the efficiency of a Pelton turbine because Pelton turbine mein casing isliye use karte hain so that there should not be splashing of water it avoids the splashing of water it directs the water toward the tail race level okay upstream se aaya downstream ke jane ke liye wo direct karta hai guide karta hai okay and in case of the operator should not come in contact directly with the turbine wheel okay for the safety provision of the operator those who are working in the hydel power station basically the casing is used. Otherwise, it does not play any role in defining the efficiency of the Pelton turbine. Okay. So this is the answer to your question, Akash. Okay. So thank you very much, and I hope that no more questions are there. Okay. So
Hello. Anyone still having any questions? Sir, I think that all doubts are clear.
Yes. And if at all any questions are there, my email ID is there. That is gkawari@gmail.com, and my phone number is also 9922966173. So you can call to me or you can write to me for any kind of doubts in this hydraulic machinery. And you know that we have authored one book on the hydraulic machinery on the New Age International. That book I would like to show you. So this is basically, are you able to see? I think,
yes, sir.
Yeah, mirror image is there. I will show you the correct image.
Sir, is it R.K. Bansal's book?
No, it is not Bansal's book. It is the book which is being authored by me and Vishwajit Ambade, sir. आपको ये दिख रही है कि उल्टा दिख रहा है?
नहीं, it is correct.
आपको सही दिख रहा है?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. यही सही है.
सही, मुझे थोड़ा उल्टा दिख रहा है, इसलिए बोल रहा हूँ.
नहीं, हाँ, हाँ. सही
है. अभी दिख रहा है?
Yes, sir.
Now it is visible?
Yes, sir.
So this is the book of hydraulic machinery by D.P. Kothari, Ambade sir and me, which we have authored. Okay, in this book you can see the various topics of hydraulic machinery, okay, including the numericals and including the multiple choice questions also. Okay, so multiple choice questions are also given in this book so that you can practice for the GATE examination and the other competitive examination like IAS examination and MPSC, UPSC examination. So this particular book is authored by us for the New Age International Publishers Private Limited, New Delhi. So the copies of these books are available in our college library. Also, you can have your personal copy or you can have the sharing copies. Means 2-3 students together can purchase the copy and books can be shared, because knowledge is basically, okay, it can be shared, information can be shared. Okay, likewise, today I am sharing.